short supply in the land of Israel, Rome was just one more iron hand in a long history of rulers that oppressed the Jews. They must have doubted they would ever see a nation restored to what it had been. Then a prophet appeared. Oh, there had been prophets before, prophets like John the Baptizer, who had come preaching that the kingdom was close. But this new prophet, this Jesus of Nazareth, seemed so different.
Jesus.
the master's words had been serious. The night he celebrated Passover with his closest friends, he acted with such love and spoke with such reassurance. He gave thanks to the bread and offered up the wine. Yet his disciples had no idea that what was about to happen would give this last meal and this last evening with him a whole new meaning. Filled with sweet memories for his disciples. Jesus told them that he loved them and called them his friends. He said that even though he was going away, he would send someone to comfort them and help them. Later that night in the garden, the sound of the soldiers' footsteps, the smell of blazing torches, and the shouts as he was arrested were ugly, painful scenes seared into their minds. Yet these were memories that could never and should never be erased. paid the price for our sin. What an amazing sacrifice. What a beautiful gift of love. And yet for those who had dared to follow all the way to Golgotha, what happened there must have brought incredible grief. Their final glimpse of Jesus was as Joseph and Nicodemus lowered his broken, lifeless body from the cross. It was the end of every hope for the new kingdom that had seemed so close. It was the darkness that falls when dreams die. It was the agony of deep sorrow and the emptiness of loss. What else was there to do now but go home?
Just lost their dear.
Jesus rose to life that morning.
He still lives today. So there's hope. Whatever your need, whatever your heartache, if you feel like an outcast, if you feel unworthy, if you're hurting or helpless, come to Jesus.
Touches you and heals you and sets you free? Well, he said it himself. If the Son sets you free, you are free indeed. Once that happens, you'll want to join all those who have been changed by his grace. You'll want to sing his praises and tell him how much you love him.